Yes, that's right. You were going to play Lionel.
And then some issues during this.
Nice. What's happened?
You were muted the whole time.
Am I muted?
You were muted the whole time.
Okay, so. Sorry. We've got to start again? Okay. So, am I back on now, Nessie? This is awesome. Am I on? Okay, we're back on here. Welcome to Rudy's 8-Ball Q Sports, run by Jay Windross. Sorry. Anyway, we're under the money games today.
Yeah.
And we've got J.R. Escoto playing against Tim Olsen. Like you were saying before, you're a little bit nervous. Being your first match.
Yes.
All I could suggest is you know, you take your time. You wait for your 30-second call and you breathe. When you're sitting in your chair, you breathe and you just don't take your eye off the table and you try and relax. Because if you're too tense, you could breathing and your heart races hard and then you're stiff when you're out there. Drink plenty of fluid. And if you need to talk to someone in there, I'm happy to have a chat in the break. If you want to come and grab me and say, listen, I don't feel so good, come and grab me and we'll have a chat and we'll see if we can help you. I wish you all the best in your game,
mate. Thank you,
mate.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. Play well.
Thanks.
Okay, we're just doing it the reverse way. Here we go, Tim. How are you, Tim?
Oh,
we're back on again, mate. Yeah.
I was just
talking to JR and he's excited for the game. I don't know whether you know each other or
he looks familiar, but I don't know him, no.
Okay, well it should be a wonderful match. I know you prepare, you always play as much as you can.
And
especially with the black ball tables here, very similar to these.
Yeah, very.
You would have put the yards in, I know you.
Yeah, you're a good practicer.
You're a good practicer, aren't you?
Yeah, I like to put in a bit of time, especially if coming up for a money match. Can't just sit around and not do anything. You have to prepare.
Yeah. Well, mate, I wish you all the best in your match.
Cheers, mate.
And like I said to JR, if you want to have a chat at any time and during a break or whatever, because things aren't happening, mate, come and see me and we'll have a chat.
Sweet. Cheers, mate.
Good luck in your match.
Thanks, mate.
BJ, how about this, mate, hey?
Yeah.
Mate, talk to me.
Oh, I've been wanting to do one of these for a while now, and my queuing and everything in my life's working out, so thought, why not?
Yeah, good on you, mate. How long you been playing?
Oh, 5-6 years.
And you're from the Sunshine Coast?
Yeah, I started playing up in Townsville.
Yes.
And then I moved down here 4 years ago.
Okay.
I've been playing at Sunny Coast since.
Okay, and you're one of the Indigenous boys?
Yes.
Yes, good on you.
Mm.
Okay, have you represented any of the Indigenous teams at all?
Oh, no.
No, you'd love to.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
And this is your first ever money game. You ever played for money before?
I have, just not
on the cameras.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
How are you feeling?
Oh, yeah, I feel good. Pretty happy with myself and my game.
All right. Well, BJ, I hope you do well, mate. I hope you enjoy it.
Oh, I love it.
Have fun.
Thank you.
Good luck.
You too.
Raimondo.
How are you?
How are you, champion?
Good.
Mate, I was just talking to your man, BJ. He hasn't had a crack at one of these.
First time,
so
true.
He's going to feel what you felt in your first one. What was that like?
It's pretty nerve-wracking, because you've got a lot of things on the line. You've got money on the line, you've got people watching you, you've got a camera in front of you, so you feel the pressure.
I've watched you grow as a player in the last sort of 18 months to 24 months. I think you're going places and really improving and putting in a lot of time. What's been the key to that, your improvement? Is it? Does the money matches help that?
It does.
Yeah.
But that's more, the money matches are more challenging. It's like put yourself out there on the line. I think change of lifestyle. What I'm doing now, working hard, doing the right things in life.
Not off the drink?
Not really off the drink, but doing, you know, making sure everything's good at home.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. Working hard, so I think if I do those things, my pool game will also get better if I'm practicing a lot, which I am, so yeah.
Ray, I love watching you play, mate.
Thanks.
And you're one of my little favourites, and I look forward to seeing you do well.
I hope I put a show on, so.
Okay, good luck.
Let's make it happen.
Good luck in your match, and we'll talk soon.
Thanks, Ray.
See you, bud.
Let's do it.
Thanks. I've no doubt you want me here. You want me to talk to you on my money match card?
Yeah, well, I know it is your card, and I'm just happy to be part of it. I'm a bit tired this morning. I'm a bit jumbly, and I think I could have done with you being in here in this seat, but I got it sorted. And
mate, you slept in until 5 o'clock yesterday afternoon, you're saying you're tired.
I know. I didn't go to sleep until 3, 4 in the morning, but. But, mate, we're ready. It's all about these guys. There's a couple of players that have never played on money events before. They're excited. They're a bit nervy.
Yep.
And
that's the way they should be.
Enjoy it, you know. Just like when, even though I've had 100 of these, I was nervous last night, and my coach said, Reedy, love it.
Yep.
Love it. Just enjoy it.
Yep.
Because if you don't enjoy it, there's no fun.
Exactly right.
You know, it's got to be fun. Anyway, Nessie's giving me the whirly bird.
Yeah, she's cutting us off.
So we can't talk anymore.
We'll be off camera and we'll talk about it, yeah?
Oh, let's have a good chat, eh?
All right. Thank you.
All the best for everyone in their matches, and I hope the viewers get some good enjoyment.
Reedy, come sit next to me, mate.
Hey, I'm a bit slow today.
Come on.
I'm a very bit...
Yeah, look, you...
Well, usually, always, but...
I know, mate, it was a big day for you, so you're very tired. But,
Cheers.
A couple of interesting matches here. BJ, first match.
Never seen BJ play, you have?
Yeah. Sunny Coast guy. And also JR on the other table, first money match too, so... New experience. I think the positive here for BJ is he's won first money match, wins a lag and gets the break, and I think that's getting your first hit on the table is probably the hardest thing, and to be able to get a break and just loosen up the arm and just get through the first shot is probably a good thing. Yes, mate.
I just watched the lag there. I lag when I lagged last night with Judgy. We only just made the balk line. So I the bed's running really quick, but the cushions aren't as responsive.
Yeah, I don't know if the cushions have actually been reclothed as well, or just the bed. So the whole
yeah, thing everything's been recovered.
Okay.
Okay, so BJ, I get to have a look at him. I've never seen him play. I love seeing new players, new blood, like I said. Like Bowie.
Bowie, Tarn.
Tarn Bowie.
Tarn Bowie, wasn't he an excitement machine? I think one thing that we do see different to people that haven't played much on a Supreme, especially on a quicker cloth like this, which we're probably going to see Tim be able to handle, is the speed of the cloth and just cueing balls rather than hitting balls. When you've come from playing on the 7 footers on our normal cloth, the 6-8-11 normal cloth that we play on, you can, and when they start to slow down, you tend to hit the ball a bit harder.
Okay.
And coming onto these, you can see players will overplay shots and lose the white because they're hitting the ball rather than cueing the ball.
You've got no sound ready.
No, that was ages
ago. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice shot from BJ to get going. Did a nice little double.
Yeah.
And
just lift it up on that shot.
A little.
And again, you know, probably went at it a little bit harder than what he needed to.
Yeah.
Nice soft screw shot. They don't rattle as much, and also you're going to get the same position on the cue ball, if not further, because throwing into rail as hard, you're going to lose its skids, you're going to lose that pace.
Yeah, JR, you know, let me know that he's really nervous,
mm-hmm.
and that's, you know, that's pretty normal.
Oh, shot.
No, great shot, but that's very normal to be nervous. And
Ray's tried to play safe there and he's missed it by about 8 inches.
Well, it's a hard table to get used to.
Yep.
And what I found, I always like to go back to myself and if I'm playing or how I handle conditions. I feel that to pick up the pace of tables, it's not real easy to do it if you're not at the table that much, you know, if you're not getting many shots, and it can take you 5 or 6, you know, they might go out off your break, out off their own, you might get one shot and then all of a sudden it's 4 or 5 nil and then you're getting your first real shots and there's 8 frames played.
Yep,
and you still haven't got used to it and you haven't been able to settle, so.
And I think it's true also, I mean, you might even get 10, 15, 20 minutes on the table for a warm-up on the table you're playing on, but then getting out there trying to play competitively, it all changes. Like, it still doesn't feel the same.
Okay, so this is JR for his first...
first visit to the table?
First visit.
Just watching him chalk his cue, he looks like a very sort of nine ball style. Is he a nine ball American style as JR?
Yeah, I think Filipinos, they're all real handy. Okay, so he's got
race to
11
as well.
Yeah, all races to 11 today, yeah. Ray's got a decent future in the game.
Yeah.
He's here's a nice ball.
Oh wow, hasn't that gone? He does, and I've seen him play over the last 2 or 3 years on your cards, and he's definitely more mature on the table now.
He's got a good future. Just hits a nice ball.
Yeah, he's overhit it.
And this is going to happen. The money tables, they're fast.
Yep, they are. And that's, again, the difference between the 7 footers to these, especially the cloth. You would hit really deep and low on the 7 footers.
The elite players, you know, they adapt a lot quicker than these other guys. They go, geez, these are quick and stuff. People that are playing in tournaments at brand new cloth, nationals, world championships, money matches, they can adapt a lot quicker. But some of these guys wouldn't have a lot of experience on the fast cloth.
No.
See how that dies off that rail? That should be doing another length.
You reckon?
Yeah, I do. I think that should be coming back.
And that's not the hinge side. That's the clip side. So that's the firm side.
BJ just playing a lovely double.
Oh, nice shot. Just gotta get off the rail.
The slide, and it might come off it.
Is that combination on? Looks like the yellow's lined up. Oh, shot. Oh, unlucky.
Here's a nice little tester for your for your first little.
It's almost a free shot, isn't it? It's something that you can just get down on. If you pot it, you pot it. If you don't, you don't. It's I don't think you can really put too much pressure on this. You pot it, you're in. If you miss it, it's over.
Yeah,
so,
tough first shot.
Definitely a tough first.
Now I don't mind being inside because it's pouring down the rain.
It is. It's gassing. Absolutely gassing it down. BJ gets his first frame. Always the hardest one to win.
Keep him on that side, but it's my OCD. It's blue on my side.
Just going in without hitting the yellow. Oh, he's played it well. Well done. Oh, he's just caught the jaw, but that's probably worked out better. How do you not caught the jaw? He's almost sitting on the eight.
Nice brace by Ray.
Got some separation.
I'm jealous of people's breaks. Do you know that? I'm actually very jealous of anyone's break.
I think you just need to look away all day, and you just need to. I think you just need to look away all day, and just not watch other people break. I think is probably the best thing for you today.
Yeah. Every time I see someone get a ball in, I'm like, I want their break. Okay, so we'll review that. We'll review that. If it's not 45, we'll see what it is, Ray. It might not be a foul. We'll see, because it could be. Yeah. So. Yeah. Yeah. What's good?
44. Then you just got to reinstall it.
Can you reboot
right
that
side,
or something?
Right side. For who won that one? JR? Yeah, yeah, right side on red.
You probably couldn't see it because where Ray was standing.
I'm generally pretty good with that too.
Have you got one on your phone? And I'll fix it on here.
So how do I cover this now?
You you just, it wouldn't have been.
So does he have 15 seconds?
I would take it.
You restart the shot clock.
Restart the shot clock.
It was 15 seconds when he was getting down to play the shot. You know what you do? You go to rackham.com/timer. Extension. Oh, sorry. Oh my God. I'm so sorry. Delete that.
Or just put zero or nothing?
Just put
zero?
Yeah, that probably work, yeah. The other option is.
So just download another free thing.
It's the one we used at Worlds. Oh, this is zoomed in way too far. How do you unzoom it? Sorry, guys.
Great shot by Timmy.
Back.
Try and use them just for, that's my personal one, that one's actually all smashed around the side, so I refuse to pay so much money.
Yeah.
Oh, great shot.
What a shot.
It's going to get good, it's going to get good, and he's found the gap. Big shot.
How can't you play like that?
Oh, damn. Does, I'm sitting in the middle
I'm,
of this.
I'm jealous of everyone's shots, their breaks, the lot.
And
Jay putting shit on me.
Can you
When do you start playing? Because I know you had a match last night, but when do you actually start playing?
So you said
Dean's
in?
Dean, yeah, Dean's in,
yeah.
Oh, shot.
Yes, shot.
Great shot. Let's go. Unmuted. Are you alright? You with me? Are you back? You are? You good?
I'm there, buddy.
Good. It's hard to hear. I know you don't like playing favourites and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to ask you. Mm-hmm. But rather than asking you for predictions, who are you most interested in seeing and watching.
That's a nice shot from JR. JR's got an interesting game. He's got a very fluent, he's like Bowie.
Yep.
Yeah, so the Asian style players that play the nine ball, the Vietnamese, the Thai, the Malaysians,
yep.
Chinese, they have a similar style. They're quite fluent, very risky.
Yep.
Who's that from? Just let him know that thank you, mate. Yeah, I don't know if I played well. I probably played okay. No, we'll probably play pretty good towards the end of the match, but as Nessie was saying, I was pretty starved of the table time, Rob. But anyway, it's not about me today. It's about the boys, the new boys that are having a run. This is my favourite part of pool. These guys having a go.
Well, you obviously have a passion for doing it, giving everyone opportunity. And
no, I just love the guys that like, how good was seeing Jacko yesterday when he got the win and he just went, yo, Billy! I love seeing that. I love seeing the passion. And Sean Lorenz, I interviewed him the other day in the after his win, and he was tearing up.
Yeah.
Because they've had three or four losses in a row, and when you get that win, it means heaps.
Yep. Absolutely. Absolutely. I wonder if Ray could have sort of finished high near the balk on this one here and sort of chipped off his yellow, claimed the turnover and got a snooker instead of now taking this on.
One more spot.
All right, guys, if you're interested in coming down to Snooker World today, we've got one spot available in the 16-man $100 entry comp starting at 1 o'clock. So if you're around the area, get on your boat and paddle down to Snooker World.
Yeah, first and second.
Work that out.
Come on down, guys. There's a spot available. Opportunity to play for $1,600. So $1,000 for first and $600 for second. This is obviously
First one's
payouts. Payouts are obviously if all entries are taken. So if we don't, obviously if we don't have 16 entries, it will.
I'll probably make it
be a little bit shorter.
I'll probably make it nine.
950, 550. I think 1,500 is all right.
1,500 is fine.
Yeah, I think that's fair. That's generally how it runs.
Just you know, unfortunately, in a 16-man comp, I'm not going to pay semis. So I'm just going to pay for top two.
That's fine. That's understandable.
That's what I want to do. And,
I mean, to pay 100 and to win 1,000 is a good chunk of change.
But whether you get 15 or 16 runners, so 500 or 16.
Yeah, so the overall prize money will be dependent on the numbers, and if we've got 15 at the moment, so 1,000's guaranteed at 15 runners. If we have anyone else pull out, and the prize pool drops down, we'll have to alter that, but at this current stage, $1,000 for first, $500 for second. We currently have 15 runners. So all money is going to be paid out. Oh, look at this. Oh, what a shot. Great shot.
Judgy had a good scrap game too. I didn't realise he had a good scrap game, you know, where he played some nice snookers and, yeah.
Oh, I think Ray's just been a
snooker player, but obviously he's had a heap of pull.
I must admit,
he's got a cool, pretty good pull brain.
Yeah, he didn't overcomplicate things. He played a very basic, very simple style, and he was happy to leave himself long balls rather than trying to force the ball into a closer position for him to take on. He was happy to leave himself. You know, let's go, right? challenging pots, but pots that he was confident in taking on rather than overplaying and possibly missing the pot or position. So, yeah, absolutely.
Shot.
A little bit of hampered queuing. You probably would have liked to have got through another.
You watch the way that they cue these. Yeah. Have you seen it? They're very confident in these kind of shots. I'm just going to just go for a walk now and go to the toilet. I'm not joking. No, it's all good. Here we go. We got Timmy.
Difficult. Played at a good pace.
Yeah, played it. That's the pace that you've got to play them at.
Exactly. And I think that's the experience he's got on the cricket cloth.
Go, Timmy. Thanks everyone for coming down last night. That was awesome. We had, 100 down here last night?
Oh, easily.
Easily 100?
Easily 100.
A lot of alcohol consumed. Some great things happened yesterday. Some first time winners. It was great to see. I didn't see the match, but Lenny won.
Lenny,
that's a great win.
Yeah, he was
Lenny 65, isn't he?
Is that all?
Is that all? Or what? You reckon he might have been 70? Okay. Well, is that all? well done to Lenny, beating Ash. Ash is one of the better players in Queensland, isn't he?
He is, and got the jump on Lenny as well. And
Lenny pulled him in.
He did, reeled him in. Absolutely did, reel him in. I think I was on commentary with Brendan Cantor, and Brendan was just making a statement that he believes that probably this rule set isn't the rule set for Lenny. Lenny obviously a very tight, very happy to slow things down and make it tough for his opponent. But he definitely turned it around last night and took the opportunities when it came. Dave Morocco, good morning to you too.
Good morning, Davo. Davo, I sent a little present to your bank account. Thank you.
Well, hang on a second.
Hang on.
What about me?
Yeah, what's Ray taking on here? Is he taking on the
He's going to have to. It's his plant? Only shot. For the value, is it? Oh, he's missed it.
So now it's back down to
It's just been, this is delayed.
It's delayed, is it?
Yeah, yeah,
okay.
This is the proper rig. Yeah, I've got a $20,000 limit per day, so I start usually paying out on Friday night and then work my way through the matches. That's how much they've been waiting 3 months. But I have to sit down and just write it all out, and then I confirm with Grant, go right, were they paying for this?
Am I back on or not?
Yes, you are back on.
Dave, mate, I really want to get you on the next card in 5 weeks. Can you get off the island? It'd be so good to have you on the card.
And it's so good to be able to see you work out how to do chat as well,
yeah,
rather than read his phone blinging off the
I know tent. How hard it is to get you off the island, but there is matches out there, and I want to get you out there, Dave.
I'd like to see Tom Milligan, morning, mate. I'd love to see you on a card as well.
Who's that?
Tom Milligan, Tommy Milligan.
Okay.
Toowoomba boy, moved up to the sunny coast, just got himself a Supreme table. It's a very, very decent ball. Very decent ball. Hopefully we can get you on a card. That's just touched. I did wobble, but I didn't.
I think it only wobbled.
He's called, but it didn't.
No, it didn't touch.
Yeah. No, I saw it wobble. Yeah, I saw it wobble, but yeah.
Thanks, Tim.
Good call there by Tim. It wobbled. He said it didn't reach the rail, though. It probably caught something. Tom and Dave, Bo reckons that Tom and Dave would be a good match. Could very well be a good match.
They're the time slots.
We've got,
confirm with Shannon whether he can do the 8:30 on the 31st versus Jake.
The next money card's 31st of May to the 2nd of June. Dave reckons it'd be better playing than watching. Well, we might have found a match on here already. As you said, Friday the 31st of May, Saturday the 1st of June, and Sunday the 2nd of June is the next money match card here at Snooker World on Supreme Tables. If you're interested in playing, make sure you get in contact with Reedy, or if you're on the stream at the moment, make sure you put your name down and say, yes, I'm interested in playing. Always looking for
and
new
I'm not,
players.
And I'm not playing.
So we're looking for someone to take the, well, you wouldn't have been the main, you wouldn't have been the main card. You would have been on the main.
I've been relegated. I've been relegated.
I think you've gone onto the Sunday card.
Sunday session.
He's on the Sunday card now. Yeah, get your names down, guys. We'd like to see the three of those guys. Who the three of them? Dave v. Bo v. Tom. Tommy versus Dave. End of May, guys. Last weekend of May. I think Ray's tried to get a snooker there. I think he might have caught the edge.
Has he left the piece?
I think he's got a little edge there.
Got the edge.
Reminder coming up after this match, guys. We've got Jeff Gannon versus Woofie Chrysouris.
Can you tell the boys
$3,000 redos and Ishtiaki Noura and Nick Oberden for playing for 2K? Yes.
Can you tell the viewers what we're going to do now for the money matches with a deposit and?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
That's what we're going to have to do from now on because of all the cancellations.
Yeah,
all right, we just have to do that now.
Yeah.
We've just got a different theory of doing it. You know, six matches cancelled. We're going to have to do a small deposit and their green fees.
Cover the green fees and a small percentage of the pot. And that will confirm your spot. I'll make sure that Reedy picks me up on the way through. Next time, are you dropping in a line? Is that what's going on?
Where's that?
Up the Moroccas,
mate. I'm. You know what, Dave? I'd like to get out there one more time before England. England's in about 5 weeks, so I wouldn't mind coming for 3 days and getting my last little bit of practice with you.
Just work on the tan,
mate. The tan's going real well. Moon tan.
Moon tan. I was sort of expecting you to be dousing yourself in talcum powder, but it's actually, you get out of the shower that colour. Absolutely, Dave, that would be awesome. But going back to what Reedy was saying, due to the amount of pullets, and obviously we've got more time slots now, so not only we're doing the Friday night and the Saturday, we've also got the Sunday as well now, so...
25% of their fee and their $100 grand.
Pot.
Yeah,
pot.
25% of their pot.
Yep.
And their green fee if they want to play.
Okay. So the time slot's not confirmed until the green fee and a deposit has been paid.
There we go. That's what we'll have to do.
So the match isn't confirmed until both players have done that. Otherwise...
How many pullouts do we have? Seven?
Messi said six or seven.
Six or seven pullouts.
Six or seven. And two of them were in the last week as well.
Yep.
So three of them in the last week, sorry.
Aaron
Goodfellow
James, that was always.
Yep, Steve Kirsten, that was always.
One, two.
That was a new that took one. Over from Aaron and myself.
Yeah, but this one was a new one.
Yep.
I don't know, six or seven cancellations, yeah. But
what?
Frozing?
No, it's all right, it's just the internet.
We are still live.
So that's what's happening, Jay, we're still... We're still live, are we?
Yeah, it looks like we're still live. It hasn't said, it says we're live, the time is running. It hasn't said that we've lost connection.
You suggested that we do that, and I think it's a great suggestion.
Well, I mean, you've never done the dirty with anyone when it's come to running off. You're not going to be running off with money, obviously.
Well, there would no way in the world, right? We've been doing this forever, and we've never let anyone down. But this is what has to happen.
Well, it's accountability, and it's the uncertainty of not knowing whether you're going to have a match or not, and then 4 days, 3, 4, 5, 6 days out, having to find another match.
Six cancellations, six time slots. However, one time slot had three cancellations on it.
Yeah.
So that's nine.
Yeah. So it was the 8:30 time slot on Friday night. Lost both their matches.
Brody Richards' match that was cancelled a few times. Well, his.
Yeah, and well that, cancelled. Yeah. But the 8:30 time slot on the Friday night was the one that both matches had cancellations on. Are you connected to your Wi-Fi?
My iPad doesn't work.
Okay, so we've got JR Escoto in a snooker here. Just having a few technical difficulties. We've got the circle of life happening.
The buffer.
Usually the Filipinos, they come off a few rails to pop balls. Did you see Bowie come off about three, an unusual one? And I thought, he's come off.
You're not connected to our Wi-Fi, are you? You're on.
No, he's not.
No.
Yeah, it has been doing
can
that.
Can we put that fan on, just on low? It's possible that the camera might be getting hot.
No, I don't think the camera's the issue. It's just that the internet is buffering. Is there anything happening in the background on your computer? Is there a security check going on or something? Or?
You
got antivirus out?
No, that always just sits there.
Just okay. Can I just...
see how it's a little bit...
Yeah, that was happening.
Not on this side though, just on this camera. So it's, for me, it's the camera. But...
Yeah.
Is that on now, Brad?
Yeah, it's on now.
Ness.
Thank you.
Now, chalk over this table.
Is it race to eight?
Good morning.
we've got a runner. This is Johnny.
Hey, Johnny.
This is Johnny's in.
Thank you. He's so downstairs on the couch. Yeah.
Just checking if you guys can hear me. Not sure which one of these are on. Yep, it's this one. All right, so we've just had the... I'll let him know, Race. So we've got one more spot. Thanks, Reece. We've got one more spot for the 16-man comp available, guys, before we can release the draw. Thank you, Margaret. So before I go creating the draw, I want to try and leave it as late as possible to announce the comp. Thank you. Ray's very focused, Shuey. He's working hard. I can see his face is all lit up with sweat. Gets pretty hot when you're playing. Whether you're playing for your own money or somebody else's, it's a tough gig. BJ's first money match with us? It is, isn't it? Why do I feel like he's been on before, or he was going to be on before another time? Anyway, talk to yourself, Vanessa. Yeah, so it's BJ's birthday today, so we'd like to wish him a happy birthday. I'm sure he'd love nothing more than to take out this win on his birthday. That would be huge. In his very first money match. Ray has played in two, I think, before, so he's a little bit more experienced. That's a potential in-off. Oh, I missed that, Shuey. I just looked over. I've got the comments on the screen next to me. Let's turn it on an angle. Oh, that's it. Oh, blub blub. We call those blub blub. Fairly evenly matched, I think, these two boys. Yeah, that was a great shot by Ray. Unfortunately, it didn't drop. And he's... BJ's going to just try and run that yellow under the red. It must go. That's a great shot. Great shot, BJ. That's awesome. I think a 99. Here I was going, he's going to go under it.
Well, let me know when you're going to do all that. We'll work the price out.
I just need one more runner and we can do the draw for the 1 o'clock match, 1 o'clock singles comp. So the singles matches, guys, will be played during the 1 o'clock money matches. Obviously,
after these guys have finished, they might want to play.
Yeah, well, they're due for 1 o'clock. And then we'll, so as soon as we can get the money matches going, we will. And we will start the comp. I could potentially turn the webcam, the interview camera, I could turn that around on a table. We could have a three-way, so you could at least see a bit of a stream. We might do that. Good, Jodes. Hey, I don't mind being inside today, actually, guys. It's pouring down outside, and it's definitely an inside day. So, I'll just jump over to this table here. So with BJ going in off there, we have Ray taking a 7-5 lead. And we have 7-5 on the other side as well on this one. Very close matches, evenly matched. The boys will come back on for commentary. They're just having a hit at the moment. 1 o'clock we have the coaching clinic with Jay. So Jay is spending 3 hours with half a dozen eight ball enthusiasts, giving them some coaching tips. He'll break them off into groups because everybody's got different strengths and weaknesses and knowledge of what they need coaching in. And then we'll be kicking off the 1 o'clock singles tournament as well. However, that won't be on the stream until the 1 o'clock money matches have completed. So we'll get as much streaming on as we can for you guys today. Time. I'm trying to get photos. There we go. Photos, commentary, changing things, scoring, creating draws. Tim. What happens? Back on in the cricket. BJ to break. Mate, I'm commentating, I'm scoring, I'm flipping screens, I'm taking photos, I'm giving rags, I'm creating comps, I'm marking off payments. Well, my wingman's not with me.
I'm here.
You're never far away, are you?
I always make sure I'm within hittable distance.
Yeah. We're getting it all done. I'm the photographer, I'm the draw creator, I'm posting, I'm saving promo pics, it's all happening. Anybody that knows me knows that, you know, by now, in a comp, I start to lose my marbles and... Oh, hello. Hey, how are you going?
Good.
That's good. I've got your stuff here.
Oh, yes, right. Yep. Thank you. I'll put my glasses there as well.
Yeah, cool. Tough day at the office for the Reeds last night. Brent didn't come off to a very good start. So Escoto just jamming that yellow in there just a little bit more. I'm videoing that, by the way. Tim was waving at me. Yeah, Brent didn't get off to a very good start last night, but thanks, Joe. but he came good. Like, he won, he was 5-all in the second set, and I think he even won the third set. He won 5 or 6 in a row there in the end, but he was just starved of table time, and the dry breaks, the in-offs, his break killed him. And Ben just broke like an absolute genius. You know, he only had, I think, 2 dry breaks in the whole thing. So you can't, different days might be a little bit better, but we just apologise to everyone who had backed Brent. You know, he works his little buns off. He fights. He's a fighter. Yeah. Usually takes his time to settle into a match. But when you're suffocated from table time and you just not you miss a shot and then the other guy pots out on you, then you're quite that's unfortunate, right? Anyway, BJ will take that. He'll go, thank you, I'll take that. Just needs to really roll this in, and then he just takes the one in the centre. Needs to work out where he's going. Whether can't work out whether he's no.
Make it.
The rail just sneak this one in and then chip those yellows down. That are 2 on the rail. Oh.
Nessie, I'll do
freckles.
I'm doing here for the PID.
Oh yes.
Is that 500?
Yeah. I think I've got my glasses on either. Yes.
I'll just put Brent.
Yeah, Brent MM. And that way I'll know. Thank you. Sucks nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yep, you're good.
It'll come through. That'll go to my running account. I'll move it across. There it comes. I got that many accounts. I spoke to the bank lady when was it? Friday. I went in to draw some money out for Sunday comp, and I said to her, I said, oh, you know, there's like 47,000 in there at the moment. I said, but on Monday, that's going to be 0, back to like 76 cents. And I just said, I hope you guys understand that, you know, I pay out lump sums. They must think I'm crazy. Within minutes, there's like 2.5, 4.5, 10. Speaking of which, for those that are watching and those that have won over the weekend, just so you all know, most of you do, and some of their backers that have agreed to pay, I will be paying out on Monday. I usually sit down. I usually go for a massage, and I am going to go for a massage on Monday. So I'll go for my massage first, come home, put a roast on, kick back, and write everything out. Confirm those payouts with Brent as well. Confirm it then with the notes in my phone, and then confirm it again before I actually start doing the transactions, because that's unfortunate. Ray's just gone, potted one out of turn there. I sit down and work it all out and triple check it, because I've overpaid Sean Field by $2,000 on one of his wins once. Bless his socks. He said, I wondered why I got so much, and he paid it back. But yeah, I was wondering why I was out of pocket so much money. So I was like, Brent, can't find $2,000. He's like, what? I'm like, I was like freaking out. But anyway, I had to backtrack every transaction and every message that I sent people. And yeah, I worked it out that it was Sean that I'd overpaid by $2,000. And that was because I did it at the event at the end of the night when I was tired and still running the event and everything. So everybody knows that, I need to sit down and do it in my own time. But it gets paid over the Monday, Tuesday, potentially Wednesday. And I'll start from the Friday matches first and work my way through to the Saturday, Sunday matches. That's only fair. So yeah, that's that in a nutshell. So BJ will accept that win gracefully. Even though Ray went hit the black out of turn there. So Ray to break. And he's come up dry. Got a feeling that might be touching on that red. Anyway, that doesn't bother BJ because yellows are the balls. That he wants? No? Okay. There you go. Actually, no, red's were the balls because of the yellow near the black and the yellow on the cushion. He's really only got one bad ball that he needs to watch out for and try and get off the rail. Hope you're enjoying the stream as well, guys. I actually really like the look of the grey felt on the stream. I think it looks really nice. At first, I never really liked the grey when we were watching the Ultimate Pool and they had the grey felt. I was like, oh, never seen that before. But for streaming, the camera does like the grey and it shows up the balls a lot better. And my equipment likes the open air environment and not these hot environments. For the Christmas Cup, guys, we are unsure whether that will be here at Snooker World at this point. We will let you know. We're hoping for that to be on the weekend of the 13th to the 15th of December. So lock that date away, save that date. That's a great shot by Ray. He's trying to tie it up. He's thinking more about his shots, which is great. But yeah, so lock that date in. I'll just double check that. I think it was the 13th. I haven't got my glasses on, but yeah, 13th, 14th and 15th of December is when we would like to have it. We sort of feel the first weekend is in December is too close to like finals and things for associations and presentation nights and things, and we normally have it around the 18th, but that's otherwise it's the 21st, 22nd, and that's too close to Christmas. So lock in the 13th, and we've just got to find a venue and make sure that we can, if we can have it here, and we'll post that out as well as soon as we know. What have I got here? 9. So we've got Tim Olsen on 9-5. These are only a race to 11-2, guys. So Tim's feeling good. He hasn't won one on our card, I don't think. I think he's played... How many times has Tim played on our card? Once or twice? This is his second, is it? Who did he play first? Scotty? Scotty Torrens? Yeah.
Mate, the way you talk, you better be playing like Stephen Andrew.
Mate,
sorry. You better be playing like
Stephen. He's doing well. He's got a comfortable lead. JR's just sitting back there. Okay, so black went in off, so black gets re-spotted. put it be right behind it.
Is it behind or in front? This one's nearly on the dock.
Grab the black bolt. Yeah, behind. Ray got a little bit of work to do to get that yellow out from behind the black, so he doesn't have to pot out here. Because that yellow is near the black, he's got to... He's got to just think about these shots and go, okay, well, or maybe it doubles across. I don't know. I can't tell from here. Maybe he might be looking at the double later on. That's off. But he's fallen safe with the white. So his white ball safety was okay. BJ probably just doubled this back down to where he's shooting from. And just a little bit too hard. We needed it to be a little bit softer, so as it sat more in the pocket. Got the snooker up there. BJ's got to try and get out of this snooker. And he has got out of it, but he's got to hit the cushion after it.
Can you just double check and touch the ball first and not the rail?
Okay, so. First, is it? Foul. Yeah, hit the rail first, unfortunately, there, guys. So that's what we were looking at. Beach was would have been hoping to hell that that didn't. Just thinking what I might do, Jay, is if the money matches are still, like when the money matches are going, I could potentially turn that around onto this table here behind you if they're playing the comp and just have a like a little third camera, third
well,
eye.
We have the semis in the final on these ones.
Oh yeah, 100%. But you know, but we could, yeah, we could potentially put it down here. I did used to have a third camera view. Yep, yep. Just one more, girl. But wait, there's more. There's one more match.
Is it?
Oh, morning.
Is it morning? Or afternoon, should I say?
Oh, yeah.
Is it fair that we put like just a cash comp picture on there while there's an actual money match going on where it's a little sort of I'm just thinking it that way.
Just give me a second, guys. I'm just going to mute this for 2 seconds. So guys, coming up at 1 o'clock, we've got Jeff Gannon versus Chris Sowers, aka Wolfie, for a 3,000 pot. And we've got Ishtiak Nora versus Nick Oberden for a 2K pot. Ishti and Nick have both been on our stream before. Pretty sure Wolfie has. I've got a brand up a Smash Crab who's been on our streams previously. You think I'd know. But there's been that many guys. And coming up at 1 o'clock as well, like I said, Jay's doing a coaching clinic for some of the Gold Coast Association members. And anybody else is doing it for about half a dozen people for 3 hours. Said my break. I thought he said they're having a break. You're having a break? I think they're having a break, so we'll jump over to table one. We'll jump over to table one. These guys are having a break on table two. I need a Jude elbow. I know a good doorman. His name's Mark Morrison. He works for Affordable Doors.
Anyway, he said he'll get on the boys and get them to come round in the next couple of days.
Yeah, he's great.
Because yesterday the remote stopped working.
Yeah.
And it's been bugging me, so I went and bought a new remote and I was trying to pair it with the motor.
Yeah. Yeah, he put a new motor in our garage door.
Yes, Ray.
But, yes, we know a good garage doorman. His name's Mark Morrison, Affordable Doors on the Gold Coast. So, yep, if your garage door, he's not a sponsor of ours, mind you, might I add, but he's a lovely friend of ours and we've known Mark for a very long time. So if your garage door breaks down, contact Brent and he'll put you on to Mark. If you need a locksmith, you've got Dave Wass. If you need a carpet man to lay carpets or tiles, you've got Jason Stafford. Who else have we got? If you need a mechanic, you've got Ash Smith. Ash Farrier. Sorry, Ash. Oh, it's been a long time trying to remember everybody's businesses. But we know everybody. If you need plasterers and tilers and stuff like that, we know people.
All right.
Need your roofing done? We've got our roofing, industrial roofing, roof coatings with Alan Talbot. You need some Botox and injectables, lip fillers, all that stuff. We go to PBC Injectables with Vicky. If you need some accounting and bookkeeping, you go to Mandy Stewart. She'll help you out there. If you need a new queue, custom queue made, tips, fixtures, ferrules, new ferrules, you go to Woodman Queues. If you need a brake queue, you go to Justin Sage. If you need a Peter Smith pool table, you can go to Pete Smith. If you need something built, you go to Darren Bampton. Who else have we got? You need a little portable home, which Brent needs one now because he lost last night. You go to Gold Coast Portable Homes. If you need a queue case, you go to Wayne Stubbs of Stubbs Custom Queue Cases. You need accessories, queue cases, racks, chalk, tips, tables, queues, you go to Typhoon Queues. And if you need your car detailed, you go to Ride and Shiny with Shane Burke. They are all Eight Ball people. They are all part of the big family. We help each other out by, it's not who you know, it's not what you know, it's who you know. And yeah, just mention Brent and Reedy's Eight Ball and they'll look after you. I'm a big believer of I'd rather pay my friends to do a job than pay anybody else randomly because they rip you off these days. That's a great pot by BJ. Take that, BJ. That's a great pot. Why not? I haven't missed a frame, have I? 9-6. Yes, there's not many people in any industry that we don't know that can't help you out. And Brent will, you know, he knows a lot of people. That's a great shot. He's got this total snooker there. So he's making Ray work for his win, should that come down to it.
That's all right. We're sitting on a group chat going on.
Oh, you're on the phone.
And Jason.
Oh. That's a foul ball in hand. BJ at the table on his birthday.
Come on.
Thanks, mate.
That's a lot of finger. It's a short next one.
He's looking up at the gods. I'm not sure he likes that. I am doing commentary, darling. Well, no one else is here to do it, so I might as well just. I might as well just do everything. Bug ears. Any pool players. Can't live with them, and you can't kill them. That's a great thing, great shot by Beach. He's hanging in there. He's not going down without a fight, I'm telling you. Oh, it was here. Oh, over there. Now. Sorry, guys, I'm just getting kisses and cuddles from everyone. Alright, sorry, hang on. I'll just jump over to table two because these guys have gone for a little break. So we've got a fair few people in here now as well. We've got the 1 o'clock money matches coming up very soon. Recently, so in the last probably month, yeah, about 3 weeks to a month. But he's been playing a lot of pool with them. He's been like watching TV with them, like walking around with them, and yeah, trying to get used to them. And that's, he misses a few shots. He's, but what do you say? His touch point or whatever is just out by a smidge. Hanging in there.
Hi Nessie, I'm back.
Are you back?
I haven't been watching these guys, but I've been watching Reedy finally have some table time.
Yeah, he was sucked dry of it last night. That's for sure.
Oh,
that's a great shot, JR. He's got to run this up the top.
It's a chance not to let this, let Tim's lead get too far.
Oh. I saw that. Well, I couldn't see it from behind him, but I could see it on the camera. I'm like, no. So Tim's second money match, JR's first one. JR just needs to put this in. Very fine. Put my glasses on so I can actually see. It's got to work out if he does happen to miss it. If it does jiggle.
Maybe a little safety here, just roll up.
Yeah.
Pretty well. Pretty clever.
Ah, oh, great shot. Where he's left him. Give him nothing, take him nowhere. He's fighting.
7 on both tables.
Am I on? Yeah, we're on.
Absolutely, we're on. Oh, no. No, it's not. Oh, dear. I almost actually put that score
Daddy?
On before he potted that. And he's missed it. I've had a mare there.
He just gave me a smirk.
Sorry, JR.
Oh, hang on, we better go back to double. So BJ broke. Got a ball off the break. Open sesame. Jay's just being a little bit cheeky with Brent and he's saying, what's it like to get some table time? Are you enjoying playing pool? He was definitely sucked of his table time last night in a 9-1 first set, but then he came back in the second set. It was 5-all in the second set. And third set, I think it might have been 6-4 or maybe 5-all in the third set, but not to be. That first set killed him.
JR gets another chance at pretty much the same shot he just played before.
Yeah. Just got to run this up the top.
Missed it again. He's going to impart it. Kiss off the white.
No. Oh. Should have just rolled that up, yeah?
Yeah, I think he's overplayed that. I think you've just got to just sort of knock it in rather than power it in.
Yeah. AJ's has fouled there. Oh. I'm looking at the same shot.
No, great shot. That's
so that
a two-front turnaround.
Let's put Tim on the hill.
Could have been 9-7, but we're 10-6. Two attempts at the same pocket, pretty much same shot, essentially.
Yeah. That was a decent pot, actually, from Tim. He just stayed down on his shot and he just pumped it.
Absolutely. Well spotted.
Shot by Ray.
Ray is feeling it. He's worn himself in it. Ray needs to run through this a little bit just to nudge that red out rather than playing up on it. See that shot there? You want to run through it a little bit. You want to catch the red rather than the yellow. If you catch the red, you're going to leave yourself on that shot in the center. Lucky he played that shot before, so he's on that yellow. I didn't play it the way that I suggested.
Around. Tim on the hill, he'd be feeling pretty good at the moment, wouldn't he?
Yeah,
second
well,
money match,
considering he
win.
Was... Considering he, you know, his opponent had two opportunities at a pretty open eight ball in the corner, it should have been 9-7.
It's hard, you know, like you try and watch both games, but it's quite hard. He got the kiss, missed the pot.
Yep.
Watch. So he needed to kiss this yellow out, and he got the kiss, but yeah, it just blue. It's one of those blue ones.
Just a rattler.
Yeah, watch. Yeah, just rattles. Yeah, just got the kiss, got perfect position.
Pretty good.
Stupid game with a piece of wood.
Who plays ball?
Dumb sport. Until I don't play ball anymore. Oh, that's a great double, BJ.
Oh,
he
needs to lag. Oh, dear.
That's a Brent Reed moment.
I think he's on in the centre, though.
You reckon?
Might have a thing cut in
the center. No, I don't think he is.
No, he doesn't. He's going off the top rail.
He's coming up the bum of one of them.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, hello.
Stop
hello.
It.
Hello.
Oh, wow.
Big Daddy.
Wowee. Yeah, how are you, mate? Yeah, we're getting there.
Why didn't I get that on video? Oh, it's on that video. Oh, hang on. Let's video this.
Yeah, nice shot.
Hello, hello.
Just going to run the angles off two, off the top hey. Right, off the side rail. No, he needs to play this middle ball, not top. He needs to play middle ball, not top.
Has he got it? No, he's looking up to the stars. I don't think he's got that.
He's got to play that middle ball. He shouldn't be playing at the top.
He's got to come up the bum of it again. You'll just hit and hope. I think I've got enough videos of these guys. Tim on the out.
I don't think he is on the out.
He's not now.
Potting for nothing here.
Yep.
Taking pocket control.
So Ray just needs to roll these in.
Probably land a little bit straight on this than what he wanted.
Should we go for the middle one? Oh, no. Top one first.
Yeah, he's gone too far.
Yeah, a little bit too far.
That's all right. He can pop this and come off the top rail and come back up to where the yellow is.
Yep.
He's just going to not... doesn't need to play down on it. He just needs to cut it into the furthest point of the jaw so he doesn't come in behind it like that. But yes, he's got a good kiss, so...
That's not too bad.
You've got to pop that to the right side of the pocket. The nearest side meant it was going to run towards the black. If you pop it to the furthest side... you give yourself more angle. You'll run more straight up and down the table rather than pushing up towards the side rail.
Well, he'll be feeling a lot better than, now that he's on the hill. But, as I always say, it's not over. Tiny houses. You know what I said yesterday, Brent, with our new sponsor? With the new sponsor, with the Gold Coast Portable Homes, I said if you lose your match, you're gonna be moving into a tiny house.
So we'll be buying
a portable home.
Not we.
No, not we. Are you going on your own, mate?
Not we.
So have you done the draw and everything there, so not yet?
Just waiting on one more runner, and then I can hit click, and then it'll go. So yeah, almost. If I don't get it, it'll be a buy.
So, as I said to Reedy, you can ask everyone to do the draw, and if someone wants to, they can pay $50 for the buy to play the buy.
Okay. Yeah.
Puts an extra $50 into the prize pool. You reckon, Reedy? If you only have 15 runners and you get end up having a buy, you offer the buy up to for someone to sell? Sell the buy to someone?
Yeah, just luck of the draw.
Luck of the draw?
We're just going to ask, as soon as these guys are finished, the winner, if they want to run in, if they want to have a go at the comp.
Well, Tim did say if he wins, he probably plays, so...
Okay.
The way that things are standing at the moment, he's favourite, he's already on the hill. Four frame lead.
Yeah, so
oops, right. Oops, right. Oops,
Ray's just.
Oops, right.
Yeah, snooking himself.
He's got the long red, but it doesn't go. Pretty sure he can see it.
Do you reckon?
Any luck?
Top one?
No luck. No, that's interesting.
Top one?
Oh, well, you better give it back to Nessie. There's no love there, Nessie.
Oh, what a result.
That's okay. Thank you. I'll put this on. Thanks, love.
I think this could be curtains here for JR. Match over
with Reedy. Tim Olsen and JR Escoto.
Yeah.
So we'll just flip over to this other match with BJ and Ray. A as I said, guys, coming up at 1 o'clock, we have Jeff Gannon versus Chris Saras, aka Wolfie, and we have Ishtiak Nora versus Nick Overton, also known as Ishti.
We've got one spot remaining.
Did Brent give a thumbs up or a no thumbs up yet?
Two. No. He said just randomise it, but he reckons we're going to fill it, so. Mark's here. What do you think of the iron on?
Tim? Are you looking for Tim?
Mark.
What?
You have the iron?
What do you want to check?
Can you just check that for a push shot, please?
Yeah.
Iron?
Iron?
Shot.
Yeah. Which one?
Not that one, the next one.
Ah, not this shot?
Gotta wait for it to come.
The shot on the yellow.
So the next one after that.
Yeah, this one.
Watching this?
There you go.
Push.
Push on.
Yep.
No.
I'll take it.
Who's that? Tim?
Yeah.
Just make sure you've got to save the file. So just not save all, not save all. Just save that one, yep. And then save that one. Yep. Or not. Oh, it's reset because that's table one.
Oh.
Now go. Yeah. Just, I was going to say, just control R or whatever it is. He's been unlucky to miss that because he has just made himself fat on that last red.
That didn't move like that before. Yes, congratulations, Tim. Where is he? I've got to get his photo.
Yep.
Just circle this.
We have Tim. 16 runners. Tim won, so Tim is playing.
11, 6. So Tim won?
Yes.
Alright, so we add Tim Olsen.
30 seconds, right? That's right.
2, 3. Oh yeah, I think I'm still out anyway. Done, Brent. I'm just posting it in a second, Dom. Just give me a minute.
Hey, my plan.
Just give me a second, Brent, please. Dom? Oh, how annoying is he? Brendan Cantor. Okay guys, so I'll post it here. So let me just get you the draw. So the draw for the 16 man comp is out, guys. I'm about to post it on the Reedy's 8 Ball page. And I will post it here for you now. It is a blind draw all the way through. Obviously you have to have the first one out. So we're first up, we will have in that it is straight knockout, it is a race to 8. We have VJ versus Blade Olsen, Craig Stevens versus Andrew Bruoff, Neil Armstrong versus Dean Whitchurch, Dean Herremeyer versus Johnny Muir, Brendan Cantor versus Brent Reed, Tim Olsen versus Aaron James, Ash Pilgrim versus Joe Hughes, and Rusty Wheeler versus Zane Clarkson. So that is the draw. It is out, so check it out. Make sure you can click in it. And yeah. What happened? I missed that. Did I miss that? Alright, so I'm going to go to the I love pool stat, but sometimes I hate it because I'm like, oh. Alright. No, I don't want to do that. Hey, Dino. How are you going? Alright, draw's done. Alright, that one's ready. I'm going to mute you guys because I need to go for a pee. Just sharing that. Are they still using the two tables for the singles comp? So, we will obviously put the matches on after the next lot of money matches. Brent didn't really time this very well because we've got money matches still going at 1 o'clock. As soon as those matches at 1 o'clock are finished, then yes, any match that we have in that comp will be streamed on these two tables. So unfortunately, and we've only got, I think, four tables because the venue is running their own Sunday comp here. So and we're doing a coaching clinic, so we only have four tables. So there's only going to be four matches on at a time anyway. So the first four matches will get up on the tables, and maybe by the time those are finished, the next lot of money matches might be finished. So we'll definitely won't have blank screens for you for the remainder of the day, and we're here until probably, I'm guessing, maybe 10 o'clock tonight by the time I pack up and get home. So anyway, I'm just going to mute this one. I think you can hear on the other one.
Thank you. answer that, guys. I will go shortly, but
BJ is just still not giving him too much. Right after this, guys, we will be kicking off our 1 o'clock matches. Jay will be kicking off his coaching, so he won't be doing any commentary. I will try and get somebody else in here to do some commentary with me. But BJ needs to just make sure of this one. Well, like for his first time on the big guard. Well done. He's a little happy camper. Oh, really? Oh, really?
Did he pay money? No.
No. Oh, hang on. No.
What?
No, and neither's Craig. I've got to get Craig's.
Can you redo the draw? Or?
No, it'll just, well.
Master redo the draw.
Well, have you got anybody?
No,
I can't. You can't redo the draw, though.
People already know.
Yes, it's already on pull stack.
Craig. Craig. Missy, what's your 100?
So, congratulations to Ray Milich on his win there. Thank you to BJ Bell. Well done. Happy birthday, BJ. It's BJ's birthday today, Dom. Just letting you know.
BJ.
So, BJ. Just played. So guys, I am going to stop this stream, get ready to start the next one. As you can see on the screen, we have Jeff Gannon, Chris Wolfie-Souris coming up, and Ishtiak Nora and Nick Oberden. They are coming up not at the moment, no, I won't be. Nick Oberden and Ishtiak, sorry guys, Brent's just talking to me. So I am going to stop this stream, go to the toilet, grab a coffee, do what you got to do. Mark is just ironing the tables and...